You know how, like, you know how you have an inner monologue where you try and figure things out about, like, what you ought to do, what you shouldn't do, like, your principles? You know, you examine your beliefs, but, like, you don't often do it just speaking, like, live on stream, and then figuring it out as you go.
Generally, half of all people don't have that, so who the fuck knows?
Well, you can't say that about women.
Yes.
Is that true that a lot of people don't have an inner monologue?
Hold on.
I'm constantly... Oh, let me ask you, is your inner monologue in your own voice? Because mine's in my own voice.
Yes, of course. Yeah, my inner monologue is... I don't know.
Deaf people.
I'm sure we talked about this on stream before, right? Like, that people have different methods of... Because you know how, like, sometimes... Well, actually, you might not know because your brain just works differently. Because, like, you can see images in your head. Like, the images sort of coalesce visually. And some people, I think that's the way that they think, like, principally, like, 100% of the time. Some people don't have the inner monologue where it is a voice that is going over thoughts in your head.
I can do pretty much all of it. Like, I can summon up images, I can summon up sounds, I can summon up voices.
I can do it in different voices.
I have all the mental powers. But here, check this out. Okay, so...
Is it in your Twitter bio that you have all the mental powers?
it's a recent survey suggests that 4 in 10 Americans do not have...
Jeez, that's a lot. An average
of 26% reported having some sort of internal speech. Up to 75% may not have had none. So
I don't. That's bizarre to me. I don't think this is true. I think this is bullshit.
So the reason why I find this kind of interesting is you've all heard of the concept of rumination, right? Like, you're somewhat familiar with that.
Just to think deeply on something.
In terms of mental health?
I think it's generally in terms of mental health. The idea would be that rumination is when a thought just sort of repeats over and over and over again, but in a detrimental way. The thought just keeps reinforcing itself, and you can't break a cycle of thinking. You just can't stop. I guess the thing is that if 4 out of 10 people don't have an inner monologue, am I to believe that, like, 4 out of 10 people have never experienced the idea of a recurring thought that they can't break?
Well, maybe they ruminate in pictures.
Maybe. I'm not sure. I guess it's just interesting to me to think that there's, like, a good chunk of people who don't think with like sentences that are formed in their head. I don't know. Yeah, well, I guess that is kind of rumination, yeah. But then it gets broken when someone drops a pen in your ass.
Yep.
that's your mental health tip for the day. If you're ruminating, drop a pen into your butt cheeks, and then you'll be okay. That'll snap you out of it.
Drop a pen into my butt cheeks?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to skim this study. I think what they're saying is they gave only 30 college students beepers, and they would randomly beeper them throughout the day. And then they would question, you know, were you having an inner monologue when we beeped you? And I don't think, maybe someone's just not, like, thinking of something specifically at the time, or more likely, people are thinking of things. When you ask them about it, they're not going to be like, oh, I was having some inner monologue, even though they really were. Because if 75% of the population didn't have an inner monologue, everyone would be like a Zen master who can meditate, because that's the hardest thing about meditation.
That is the hardest thing about meditation.
You're not supposed to think words. You can think in pictures, but you're not supposed to think in audio words anymore.
Generally, the idea with meditation is that you want to put yourself... It's mindfulness, right? Where you exist in the present moment without any judgment of the things that are around you. It's just perceptions of things, which I think is really difficult to achieve as a person, because human brains are pretty mired with concepts and value judgments and things like that.
Well, and you're always thinking of other shit.
Well, you're often thinking about the future and the past. I think I don't know where the quote comes from, but it's a sentiment that kind of follows that, like, a Buddhist monk, right? They've achieved something really exceptional if they can go for a minute, like, just looking at a clock, and their mind doesn't wander off. Like, whatever that means to them, that their mind doesn't go... Oh, wait, that's something I need to do. Fuck. Oh, shit, that's something that stressed me out. Like, that you're able to focus on that clock for a minute. That's incredible. Humans think. We just think persistently.
Right. The thoughts rise. These Buddhist monks, man, sometimes when they meditate, they're just on fire.
I get it.
Well,
here's the thing. This conversation came up back in the NPC meme. When the NPC meme was the big meme of the day, everyone was talking about these studies. And Aiden Powell, we have to watch it now, obviously, because it's a different video, but for off stream, if you wanted to see it later, Aiden Powell did a big old video going into all the studies on people without inner monologues. I'll just put it in the group chat.
I don't buy any of this. This all seems like
bullshit. I heard that
seems
some...
like there's people without a monologue. No, I know one. I know a YouTuber doesn't have one. He's a friend of mine.
I don't know. Well, so here's the thing.
But dry bread.
I don't know that I can ever really know what's going on in other people's heads. So it's kind of hard for me to like someone can tell me I don't have an inner monologue, but like that doesn't I don't know what that means, right? You're self-reporting something. Like it's hard for me to know what that means. We might have a different understanding of what an inner monologue means. You might just be lying to me.
It might be, yeah.
It might be that you don't fully understand. Like, it might be that you don't identify.
It's the way you phrase the question to them. Like, if you said, do you have an inner monologue? They might answer differently than, do you talk to yourself in your head?
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
I feel like these are important things because it's not like this isn't something you can observe from the outside necessarily. This is someone you're having to rely on people accurately reporting the state of their own minds. Mm-hmm.
And someone in chat said Aiden concluded and explained why it was a bad study and it doesn't show what it claims to show.
Oh no.
Dev,
get out of here.
Well, you know what? For the purposes of today, I am 100% willing to accept that Denims has no inner monologue.
I guess it's more.
Go ahead.
Go for it, actually.
All right. Dev, do you remember this? It was going around. I don't think it was a big thing. But it went around because someone on Twitter had said that they cannot picture objects in their head. And a lot of people said, oh, yeah, that's bullshit that people can even do that. I don't believe it at all because I can't. And it was this it was one of those sort of resurgence of the NPC meme kind of things because people saw that. People saying that they can't picture objects in their head. And I guess that's just another thing that some people cannot do. Well,
oh, no, that's what Madry Bread has. Hold on. What's the name for that again?
Someone said that it's called aphantasia. Is a phenomenon.
Yes, aphantasia. Yeah, you cannot visualize imagery.
I fall into that camp somewhat. I mean, I can picture things in my head, but they're very fuzzy and not clear.
Aphantasia is a phenomenon. It is a phenomenon in which people are unable to visualize imagery.
Yes.
Which is strange to me because I've always been able... I assumed that was a normal thing that minds could do.
Well, I guess this is where we get into the interesting things in general about consciousness, that people have a different experience of reality.
And how we describe it may have differences as well. Like,
yeah, and I
because I'm such a visual person.
I think that... I remember Tony Robbins talked about how there are like three different... I'm sure that there are more than three, but it's interesting as a subcategorization that there are a lot of people who focus on visual stimuli, a lot of people who are more oriented around auditory stimuli, and then the third one is more vague. It's like it's kinesthetic or something. Yeah. Yeah, where it's like vibes, I guess, like a feeling of vibes.
Kinesthetic is touch sense or position in space.
Yeah.
Is how I operate.
And that it's the reason why someone... I'm sure we talked about it on EFAP before where someone can, it's such a common thing where someone can very angrily say, this is a horrendous point you made. I'm not sure why you made it for this reason. And I might even throw swears in it and they're like, wow, calm down. Where someone can calmly say, you know what? You're a pretty pathetic, feeble, worthless human being, you know? And then someone won't respond as negatively to that, even though the sentiment is way harsher. And it's just because they respond more to tone.
Kindly. Yeah.
It's a common thing, I think, that
you're saying they're like a dog.
Yeah.
Excuse me.